New backdrop stuff, new camera. Insects tend to get a pretty bad rep. Yes, humans usually like small animals with big eyes, but insects went too far with it and seem to be immediately disqualified. Except for one group, the weevils. These tiny creatures seem to be otherworldly and even magical in appearance, like something out of Harry Potter or Alice in Wonderland. Weevils have become the most cherished insects around, and even have a Reddit fan club called Weevil Time. Today I'm going to be introducing you to some with appearances and reputations that will surprise you. So sit back and relax while I show you some weevils I think that you will like. Let's get the general information out of the way. Well, as general as we can get. Weevils are impossible to generalize. They've been around for like 200 million years and have really become their own at a species level. One thing we can say for sure is weevils are tiny. We're talking millimeters. But what makes a weevil? Well, the majority of them have a rostrum, that elongated snout, cute as fuck, with chewing mouth parts at the end of it. Not to be confused with the proboscis that many insects have that are piercing and sucking mouth parts. No, these are chewing mouth parts and are objectively much cuter. Many weevils also have elbowed antennae, often coming off of that rostrum. The Reddit fan page often describes weevils as having boots and snoots. Snoots, obviously, the rostrum. And they also tend to have some pretty cottagecore looking feet. Most weevils can fly, and all weevils are beetles. Yeah, beetles. If you've been watching my content for a while, you've probably heard me say the beetle fact at least once. I say it all the time, and I'm gonna say it again. 25% of all discovered animal species are beetles. One in four animal species ever discovered is a beetle. Do you know how many beetles that is? 350,000 species, dude. There are so many beetles. And the biggest taxonomic family of beetles is the weevils. Circulionidae. Circulionidae.
Curculionidae.
Curculionidae, also known as the true weevils. Yeah, fuck. It's the crab situation all over again. There are true weevils, about 83,000 species, and then another 12,000 species that are not true weevils, but still technically weevils. Some true weevils don't even look like weevils, like bark beetles, which are so unweevil they got kicked out of the club and don't even get to be called weevils. And then other beetles, like biscuit weevils, are called weevils but are not true weevils and don't even look like weevils. It's all sorts of fucked up, and it's only gonna get worse. If we total it up, the true and false weevils, it's about 95,000 species that have been discovered. Scientists estimate there's about 220,000 species total, which they believe will take another 650 years to describe. It's gonna be absolute mayhem. Let's get back to the snoot, with the chewing mouth parts at the end. They use this to pummel into a variety of plants, depending on the species, and are often viewed as pesky little rats. Despite being the size of a grain of rice, their lifestyles can lead to the damage of crops on an incredibly large scale. They obviously eat the plants, but they also use the plants to lay eggs in them. And once the eggs hatch, they feed on that plant even further. From our perspective, causing even more chaos and destruction, but from their perspective, getting a nice little nutritious meal as a welcome to the world. One of the easiest examples of this process is a weevil that I've talked about before, that look like they have shops to sell little potions and trinkets and need wizard hats. Everyone's favorite weevil, the acorn weevil.
That's the cutest fucking thing I've ever seen in my entire life.
Notorious for infesting the, you guessed it, acorns of oak trees, making them absolutely useless. However, they do not give a fuck about that. As you can see, acorn weevils have a needle-like snout, ideal for drilling into young nuts. Females approach an immature nut in the summer and use their antenna to determine if the nut is suitable and soft enough to get into. I don't know if anybody else has this problem, but you know those cardboard boxes that hold litter in them? You have to punch a hole into it with your thumb to get the litter out, and it's hard as fuck because they don't actually perforate it, so then you're just fucking sitting there pushing with your life to get it open, and then you give up, you grab a sharp object, stab it in, make your own perforations because they couldn't do it for you, and then you finally get it open and it's just unnecessarily difficult. Well, that's essentially what the acorn weevils do. They make cuts on the surface of the nut to loosen it, and then punch through it and drill right into it, rotating their head, looking like an animatronic. Like, weevils don't look real. Once she's in, she lays her eggs into the hole she just made and leaves them be. The eggs hatch into babies and then feast on the inside of the nut. They stay there until sometime in the fall when it's time for the acorn to drop to the ground. The babies chew themselves out of the nut and go to their next home, the soil, for another like 2 years until they become an adult, which honestly sounds like a pretty good setup to me. But some animals that like nuts, like birds and squirrels and us, do not like that, since empty nuts that baby weevils were living in is not a particularly pleasant meal. Others, actually turns out, don't give a fuck under the right conditions. Researchers in 2007 determined that ungulates, like deer and wild boar, will eat infested acorns with absolutely no discrimination if the acorn supply is low. They figured eating weevil-infested nuts compared to no nuts was the lesser of two evils. That aside, I think we can all agree that this particular look of weevil is working really well for them. So I'm gonna introduce you to some weevils that kind of have the same vibe. The boll weevil, found in the US, Central, and South America. They like cotton. And actually in Alabama have a monument honoring them as if they are some sort of Greek god. But not because they are weirdly adorable and have images online of them riding bicycles and playing button guitars. Despite looking extremely polite, boll weevils are the most destructive cotton pest in North America and are considered the most hated agricultural pest of all time in the United States, costing the US like $20 billion since arriving. Quite the title for such a little guy. So boll weevils are originally from Mexico, made their way to Texas in 1892, and they immediately went for the jugular, invading cotton fields all over Texas, spreading to the southern United States and even up, I think, into the Dakotas. And this happened quick. They traveled like 100 miles per year and were pretty resistant to pesticides because the eggs were inside the cotton bolls rather than the outside. And their life cycles are so quick that they could have like 13 generations born in a single cotton season, which is fucking nuts. This became a weevil war, with some fields apparently 100% infested, played some role in the Great Depression, and people just couldn't grow cotton anymore. The weevils were clearly winning. They tried to get rid of them with viruses, every single possible pesticide, and even imported fire ants from Guatemala at some point. By the 1970s, the largest eradication program the US ever saw was started, which has since been insanely successful. I think all of the boll weevils are gone for now, except for some parts of southern Texas. Okay, so what about the statue? How does this play into it? Well, in 1916, a town called Enterprise, Alabama was feeling the wrath of the evil weevil, as was everywhere else. Their cotton was obliterated. But instead of trying again the following season, that a lot of different areas did, they decided to switch up their crops, stop the weevil in their tracks entirely. And they became extremely successful with peanuts. They were raking it in. The weevils indirectly put Enterprise on the map, and so they wanted to honor it. The statue originally had a fountain in place of the weevil, but then people came together, they decided they needed to put a weevil there instead to honor it for its destruction that ultimately led to the town's fortune. All hail the boll weevil. You might be wondering why such a devastating weevil was put in a video titled, "Weevils I Think That You Will Like." This would arguably be the weevil people do not like. And to be honest, I was not expecting to go into all of that. I didn't know any of that existed. I thought it was cute, and I was just gonna be like, look at this cute weevil. Look at it riding a bicycle. Look at it playing a button guitar. But then I read like the first thing about them and just went down this rabbit hole, and I found out about the statue and I obviously couldn't look back. So anyway, here's another one I think that you will like. Rhinastis laternus. There's no common name for this weevil, but they clearly need one. Maybe the big boot weevil. Please leave your suggestions in the comments, because we gotta figure this out. This weevil is notably cannibalistic in their larval stage, so maybe the cannibal weevil. The larvae have been observed committing hunger games on each other in the bamboo shoots they reside in, eating each other until only one remains. All right, so we've gone over the cute snoot weevils. Now get ready for the extensive neck weevils, specifically the Madagascar giraffe weevil, found in, you guessed it, Madagascar, and named after its, you guessed it, long neck. They were originally discovered in 2008, so not much is known about them, other than the fact that they look like giraffes. But they're usually found in trees called giraffe beetle trees, which are also only found in Madagascar, and they seem to live their entire lives on it. And like giraffes, the males seem to use their necks as weapons, fighting other males to impress the ladies, and maybe possibly for territory shit as well. There are multiple giraffe weevil species, many unrelated to each other, but they tend to be some of the larger weevil species that we know of. The largest, the New Zealand giraffe weevil, can get up to like 3.5 inches long. Absolutely gargantuan for a weevil. Kind of looks like a French chef to me, you know? He looks like he serves souffle. And one that kind of has the same vibe as this, but like much worse, but also I think that you will like, is the hose-nose cycad weevil. Quite the smeller on this one. Well, not smeller, chewer. Quite the chewer on this one. The females actually hold the record for the longest snout compared to body length in weevils that we know of, getting up to like 3 times the length of their body. They're found in southern Africa and born to the seeds of cycads. I don't know how they get around like this, to be honest. I feel like it's as debilitating as carrying around a 2x4 in the lamp section of Home Depot. The thing about weevils is, once you know a few, you kind of get the gist, you know? You know what the fuck is going on. They like nuts and fruits and plant material. They weevil their ways into it. So these last few are just like quick, rapid-fire weevils I think that you will like. First, the jewel weevil, found in Central America and South Florida, where it might have been accidentally introduced in banana shipments in 2002. They like grapevines. And the polka-dotted clown weevil, flightless weevils found in the Philippines. There's a variety of subspecies that have a variety of colors and like a variety of plants, and they kind of look like rainbow-eyed dipping dots. Kind of like the glitter weevil, which have photonic crystals all over them, giving them that shimmery glow. They live in Central and South America. There's also the Schoner's blue weevil that looks like a Baja Blast, found in New Guinea, and the willow weevil that looks like bird shit, found in Europe. I would also like to turn your attention to another long-neck weevil, Trochilus smilus Tracheolysmus protractus. They are definitely in need of another common name as well. So let me know in the comments. There was also another weevil that I was having a hard time identifying. This one. It's so cute. It looks like a dog. It also happens to be the top image search result for stupid looking bug. I was having a hard time narrowing it down, so I asked my Instagram story if somebody could identify it, and it seems to have been narrowed down to the genus Lyxis. This picture was also apparently taken in Yunnan, China, so that's where we're at for now. Nevertheless, I would argue this is my favorite weevil that I know of. All right, it's time for this week's questions. First one. One time I was in my dad's house and I saw a piece of dust move. Is it just the wind or some sort of bug? It could have been a masked hunter, a bug. Specifically an assassin bug that uses dust or lint as camouflage when they're a nymph, like a teenager. Their bites are painful and can lead to swelling, so don't pick it up.
Thanks.
Next, what are some creepy butterfly facts that you might know? Some male butterflies have organs called coromata, or hair pencils, that are inflated and produce pheromones to attract female butterflies. Not super creepy in butterflies, but definitely can be in moths, like Creatinotus genghis, also known as the Baphomet moth, that I talked about in the freak edition of What the Fuck Is This? It's just a bit unpleasant to look at. If you have a weird animal you want identified, let me know in the comments and I might feature it. And if you like this video, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss my next long form video on the largest ape to ever exist that we know of. Check out my Patreon for our Discord server and live streams. And for now, stay curious. The world has a lot for us to learn. See ya!